Hey, what's up, you guys? Welcome back to the show. So while everybody's hyped about the price of Bitcoin and all the gains you can make overnight, let's take a step back and understand how cryptocurrencies work. So cryptocurrencies like Bitcoin, Ethereum, and other altcoins are blockchain-based projects. This is a fundamental structure and a backbone of these currencies. So before we start trading or investing any real money, I believe it's very important that we first understand how these currencies work. So what is a blockchain technology? If you ever use apps like WhatsApp, Facebook, or Twitter, I'm sure you are aware that within these apps, you can write a post, upload images, upload videos. These videos are then not stored on your local device like your phone or your computer. However, they are stored on a server or a database. So a database or a server is an equivalent of a blockchain. A blockchain, however, differs from this typical of a database as it stores data and blocks, and these blocks are then chained together, hence the blockchain. As new data is constantly coming in, it is stored in fresh blocks. Once the block is filled with enough information, it is chained to the previous blocks. New data is then stored to the next block, and the system keeps repeating itself over and over again. So you may be wondering, what data are we talking about here? Data just basically means information. In case of Bitcoin, this could include Bitcoin transactions. It can be anything: images, videos, information, critical information, government identity information, and all that stuff. Let's take, for example, this video you're watching right now. I filmed this video from my camera, then edited it on my computer, then uploaded it to YouTube. You can only watch this video if I have successfully uploaded it from my computer to the YouTube's database. If you are subscribed to this channel, of which you should, YouTube will then send you a push notifications letting you know that Vusi Designer has uploaded a new video and you should go and check it out. Now let's make another example, because if I'm honest with you, I just made that YouTube example so that you know you should subscribe and turn on your post notifications so you never miss a video from this channel. If I actually type and send you an email, I'm actually not sending you the original email, I'm sending you a copy of whatever that I've touched. Anyway, when you send this email, it doesn't go directly to the intended recipient. However, it goes to the database. The database stores the email and makes a copy of that, then forwards the copy to the intended recipient. So let's recap. I send you an email, it doesn't come directly to you. It goes to the database. The database stores the email, then sends you a copy of whatever that I sent you. Now, in terms of the blockchain technology, because Bitcoin uses a decentralized network that doesn't really rely on a single database, Bitcoin relies on millions of computers called miners to process data and verify information like Bitcoin transactions. Remember the email example that I made earlier, that when I'm sending you an email, I'm actually not sending you the original email, I'm sending you a copy. Now, when it comes to Bitcoin or any form of money, it's very important that when I send you digital money or digital assets, I still don't have the original, and that I cannot send the original money to someone else. Now, in cryptography, this problem is known as double spending. If I send you Bitcoin, I'll need a device like a phone or computer, a Bitcoin wallet, then your Bitcoin wallet address. Once this transaction is sent, it will then be broadcast to the Bitcoin network called the blockchain. A group of computers called miners or nodes will then verify this information. Once that information is verified, you will then receive your Bitcoin. So basically, blockchain is a decentralized system of recording information such as Bitcoin transactions that it makes it difficult for anyone to change, cheat, or hack. Blockchain is essentially a digital ledger of transactions that is duplicated and distributed across the entire networks of computers. So let's display a side-by-side example. On one end, we are sending an email. On the other hand, we are sending Bitcoin. To send either an email or Bitcoin, we'll need a device. After that, we'll need an application. This can be a Gmail application or a Bitcoin wallet. To send an email, you need a recipient's email address. Similarly, on Bitcoin, you also need a recipient's Bitcoin address. Type the email you want to send and input the exact amount of Bitcoins that you're intending on sending and press send. As mentioned earlier, when sending an email, it will go from your phone to the server, from the server then to the intended recipient. When sending a Bitcoin, it goes directly from your device to the blockchain network. Once your Bitcoin transactions have been verified or at least confirmed by at least three confirmations, it will then reflect on the recipient's wallet. Basically, that's how blockchain works with regards to the Bitcoin transactions. The computers or nodes that are responsible for confirming Bitcoin transactions are called miners. In the next episode, we'll go in depth on understanding how does Bitcoin mining work. Now, this was an oversimplified example of a blockchain technology. In the next video, we'll look at Bitcoin mining, as these are the nodes that secures the network and validate Bitcoin transactions. It's very important to note that this is just one of the many examples where blockchain technology can be applied. Obviously, in this channel, we'll talk about making money online and trading cryptocurrencies. So I felt it was very important for us to only look at the Bitcoin aspect of the blockchain technology. Once again, this was episode number 3 of our crypto masterclass, and I'll see you on episode 4. If you have any question, leave the comment on the comment section below, and I'll see you on the next one. Goodbye for now. Peace.